Hello children, welcome to another session of exercise 4.4. In part 1 we have discussed 4 problems. Okay, next 5th, 6th and 7th problems we will discuss in this session. Let us write the 5th problem. First I will draw the figure. 5th problem. M 30 degrees and 5y A is B, 2x B, x minus y is C. So this is a figure and question given. Question. Find the values of x and y for which the lines AD and BC become parallel. AD and BC become parallel. AD and BC parallel. Okay? What is AD, BC? This is AD and this is BC. These two are parallel. When these two are parallel, this is transversal. Okay? When this is transversal, the angle 5y, angle 2x, what is the relation? Interior alternate angles. Okay, interior alternate angles. So the sum of these two are equal. These both are equal, we can say that. And when these two are parallel and this is transversal, angle 30 and angle x minus y. These two are, one is exterior and one is interior. So these two are corresponding angles. Okay, when these are parallel, considering this as a transversal, these both are equal. And this is a transversal when AC as a transversal, these both are equal. Why? They are corresponding. And these two are alternate interior angles. Okay, from these two relations we can find the value of x and y. Okay, right. Solution. AD parallel to BC. AD parallel to BC. And when AB is transversal. AB is transversal. AB is transversal. 2x is equals to 5y. 2x is equals to 5y. Why 2x is equals to 5y? What is the relation between these? Interior alternate angles. Interior alternate angles. From this we can find the x value is equals to 5y by 2. Let this be equation 1. 2x is equals to 5y. X is equals to 5y by 2. This is equation 1. Okay. And second case. AD parallel to BC. AD parallel to BC. And AC is a transversal. When AC is transversal. transversal. AC is transversal. X minus y is equals to 30 degrees. X minus y is equal to 30 degrees. Why? Because these are corresponding angles. These are corresponding angles. Okay. This x minus y is equals to 30. These two are corresponding angles. From this, substitute the value of x here. Okay. To solve this equation, substitute the value of x here. Right. Substitute equation 1. Let this be equation 2. In equation 2. Equation 1. In equation 2. When we substitute this x value, what is here? 5y by 2 minus y by 1 is equal to 30 degrees. Okay. Right. Find the LCM. It is 2. 5y minus y into 2 and 2 into y. It is equal to 2y is equal to 30. Okay. This implies 5y minus 2y means 3y by 2 equal to 30. Okay. This implies 3y equal to, or y equal to, direct value, right? Y equal to 2 transpose into here. That is 30 into 2 by 3. Okay. 3 ones are 3 tens are 10 into 2. Y equal to 20 degrees. Okay. From this equation 2, we have find the value of y equal to 20. Substitute y equal to 20 in equation 1. Substitute y equal to 20 in equation 1. What is y equal to? X is equals to 5 into 20 by 2. Okay. 2 1s are 2 10s are. So, x is equals to 5 into 10. That is equal to 50 degrees. What is our y? 20 degrees. What is our x? 50 degrees. So, x equal to 50 and y equal to 20. This is our solution. Okay. Find x and y is given. How we have found that? In AD is parallel to BC. In first case, AB is a transversal. When AB is a transversal, 5y and 2x. These two are interior alternate angles. So, these both are equal. From that, we find the value of x is equals to 5y by 2. And another case, if AC is a transversal, when AC is a transversal, 30 and xy. These both are equal. Why? These two are corresponding angles. From this, we can find the value of the, from these both equations, we can find the value of x and y also. Okay, children? Please copy these. Okay, children, is it finished? Let us discuss sixth problem. This all related to the parallel lines, transversals, and angles relation. Okay, next sixth question. In the figure. Values of x and y in the figure you have to find. What is our figure? X, y, 140. Is 30 degrees. Okay, find the values of x and y in the figure. Okay, here no names given. A, B, C, like no names given. Find the values. How we can find? First observe this figure. This is a linear plane. Angle at a point. This is a linear plane. So, the sum of these two is 180 degrees. Okay, from this we can find the value of this angle y. And this is an exterior angle. The sum of these two is x. Exterior angle, the sum of these two is x. So, with this we can find the value of x. Right? Solution. No names are given, nothing is given. What we have to write is y plus 140 degrees is equals to 180. Okay, from the figure, right? From the figure, y plus 140 degrees is equals to 180 degrees. Okay, from this, what is y? Y is equals to 180 minus 140. It is equal to 40 degrees. Y equal to 40 degrees. Okay, when y 40, by exterior angle property, x is equals to 30 plus y. Okay, and x is equals to y degrees plus 30 degrees. From exterior angle property, okay, from exterior angle property, x y plus 30 is equals to x. So x is equals to 30 plus 40. That is equals to 70. Okay, x is equals to 70 and y equals to 40 is our answers. Okay, please copy this simple question. Okay, is it finished? Let us go for seventh problem. First question. In the given figure, segments shown, by arrowheads are parallel. Find the values of x and y. Okay, arrowheads are given. They are parallel. Okay, this is the figure. Arrow, and it is 30. And it is 45. Y. Here X. Okay, no names given here again. This is the figure. And X and Y values we have to find. First observe this figure. These two are parallel given. When these two lines are parallel, this is transversal. Okay, this is transversal means what is the relation between these two angles? Alternate, one this side and another side of the transversal. So x is equals to 30. From the figure, these two lines are parallel, this is transversal, x equals to 30. Okay, and if this is a transversal, we can say this is 45. This is 45. Here x is 30 and another angle of this figure is 45. Again, this is alternate interior angles. To find y, what is the relation here? Exterior angle. Y is forming an exterior angle. So angle y is equals to 30 plus 45. Okay, is it clear? To find the value of x, these two are alternate interior angles and y is an exterior angle. If we find the exterior angle here, it is equal to 45 plus 30. If we find the exterior angle here, it is equal to 45 plus 30 only. Okay, from the figure, solution, from the given figure, angle x is equals to 30 degrees. Angle x equals to 30 degrees. Why? Because these two lines are transversal and that is alternate interior angles. When x equals to 30, this y is exterior angle to the given triangle. Okay, for this triangle, y is an exterior angle. Okay, so angle y is equals to, or y is equals to 30 plus 45. Why it is exterior angle property? Exterior angle property. Y equals to 30 plus 45. So it is equals to 75. So therefore, x equals to 30 and y equals to 75. These are the values. Okay. Copy this. First, we have to understand the figure. From this figure, what is given? In this figure, these two are parallel given. Parallel means it is transversal. When it is a transversal, what is the relationship between these two? These two are alternate interior angles. So alternate interior angles means these both are equal. angle. So when exterior angle is equals to opposite, the sum of these two equals, the sum of these two angles. So 30 plus 45 equals to y. Okay, please copy this. Okay, is it clear? Next question, let us go for 8th problem. Eighth problem. In the given figure, sides QP and RQ, of triangle PQR. Produced two points, S and T respectively, if angle SPR is equals to 135 and angle PQT equal to 110, find angle PRQ. And this is the figure. Q 110 degrees extended to T, P 135 degrees extended to S, here R. Okay, first listen carefully what is given, what you have to find. In the given figure, sides QP and RQ, extended to S and T. These two are extended and angle SPR, this SPR is 135, angle TQP, okay, or PQT, this is 110 degrees. find this angle R, interior angle you have to find. This both are exterior angles given. If it is opposite angles are given, if we can find the exterior angle. But it is given both exterior angles only. How can we find here? How can we find the angles here? Yes. Angle PQT, PQR. That means this PQT, PQR. This both can form a linear pair. That means here the sum is 180. From this we can find the angle PQR. Okay, again here angle RPS, this is 135, and angle RPQ, RPQ at angle P, this is also forming a linear pair. So here the sum is 180. From this we can find the value of P. Q we will find, P we will find. After that, triangle property, angle sum property, this is R we will find. Okay, angle sum property of the triangle. First, what I am writing is angle PQT plus angle PQR. PQT means this exterior angle, PQR means interior angle, this. Okay, from the figure, angle PQT plus angle PQR is equals to 180 degrees. Why? Because it is a linear pair. It is a linear pair. This is PQT, PQR. This is 180. Okay. From this, angle PQT is equals to 110 plus angle PQR is equals to 180. Okay. From this, angle PQR is equals to 180 minus 110, that equal to 70. Angle PQR equal to 70. This angle is 70. This angle is 70. And next, here it is given, angle SPR. SPR is 135 and RPQ, the sum of these two is 180. Again, that is, they are forming a linear pair. Right? Angle SPR plus angle RPQ equals to 180. These two angles I have written. SPR, RPQ, this angle equals to 180. Again, it is equals to a linear pair. SPR is given 135. SPR is 135 plus angle RPQ is equals to 180. This implies to find the angle RPQ, 180 minus 135. 180 minus 135, it is equal to 45 degrees. Okay. It is equal to 45 degrees. So, angle RPQ is 45 degrees. This is a triangle. From this, angle QPR, RPQ. RPQ, PQR plus angle R. Here it is only one. So, angle R, the sum of the three angles is 180 degrees. Okay, now, right? In triangle PQR, angle PQR plus angle R plus angle RPQ, the sum of the three is equals to 180. Angle PQR related to Q plus angle RPQ plus angle R equals to 180. The sum of these three is 180. Why it is? Angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property of triangle. Okay. From that, these two are, one is 45 and another one is 70. Now, 70 plus 45 plus angle R equals to 180 degrees. Okay, 70 plus 45 means 150 plus angle R equals to 180. This implies angle R equals to 180 minus 150. 180 minus 150, that is equals to 165. This is angle R equals to 165. This is 150 and that is 165. Okay, listen again, here I am explaining. To find the angle R, it is given extended angles, angle B and angle T is given. To find the angle R, first find the interior angle related to the triangle. This is 70 and this is 45. After this, in this triangle, by using angle sum property, we can find the angle of R. Angle R is equals to 165 degrees. Okay, is it clear? Please copy this. Okay, sorry, 180 minus 15, 65, only 65. Okay, is it finished? In the figure only we can find the solution. Write steps for that. For every problem. do the 10th and 11th questions. I will explain here how you have to do. Here it is 35 and it is 53 given, and this is 10th one. Listen, I am explaining this 10th and 11th you have to do homework. Okay, in the given figure AB parallel to DE, this is AB and DE. AB parallel to DE given, and angle BAC is 35, BAE is 35, this is 35, and angle CDE is 53. Find angle DCE, this angle you have to find. Okay, is there any idea to find this? C you have to find. How can we find this? Just think of it. Yes, AB and DE, these both are parallel, means this is transversal. When this is transversal, angle ABC is equals to angle CED or DEC. Okay, this is transversal, means here alternate interior angles. Angle ABC is equals to angle CED equals to 35 degrees. Okay, when it is 35 in triangle CDE, two angles are given. Find the other angle by angle sum property. The total sum is equals to 180. So you can find the angle C. Is it easy? Yes, very easy. You have to do. These two are parallel given. This is transversal. So this alternate interior angles. From this is a triangle. You can find this by angle sum property of the triangle. Okay, and the 11th question is given like this. Is the figure 11th question is given. R is 40 degrees, P is 95 degrees, and T it is 75, S U given. Okay, question, what is the question given? In the given figure, if the line segments PQ and RS intersect at T, these two lines intersect at T, and angle PRT is equals to angle RPT is equals to 95, TSQ equals to 75, these given angles. Find SQT, this we have to find. SQT, how much you have to find? Okay, first observe this figure. In this figure, this is a triangle. In triangle PRT, one angle is 40, another angle is 95, and you have to find angle PTR. Angle PTR. This R sum equals to 180. Okay, from this you can find the value of T, and vertically opposite angle formed here. So whatever the angle here is, if it is X, here also X. If it is Y, here also Y. If it is 30, here also 30. Okay, from this triangle you can find the value of T, and these both are vertical totally opposite angles. So angle STQ is also equal to this triangle. Okay, after getting this, this is a triangle. In this we know two triangles. Again we can find the triangle SQT by angle sum property. Okay, have you understood this? Okay children, in this figure alternating, here using angle sum property, by angle sum property we can find the value here, and these both are equal, means vertically opposite. Okay, now the sum of these two and these three is 180 degrees. From that we can find the values. Draw these two figures in rough note, and these two you have to do homework. Draw these two figures in rough note. Okay, for every problem you have to study the figure, which are intersecting lines, which are parallel lines, what is the transversal there. Okay, that all you have to find first. Okay, homework for exercise 4.4 part 2. Exercise 4.4, 10th and 11th problem. 10th and 11th problem I have explained there how you have to do also. Okay, these two problems do in homework. Do homework for this session. Okay.